peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama. I'm the Truth Seeker on my way to work this morning and want to do a little short video on educated people. You know, I work for educated people. I work in a system of educators, right? And let me cut this down. Let me cut this down for y'all. I'm going to tell you, I work in a system of educators. You know, people who are educated, most of them have at least a bachelor's degree. But you know what I've discovered? I discovered that educated people can be some of the dumbest people on the planet. I mean, they do some of the stupidest things. You know what I'm saying? And for all their education and being held up because they have all these degrees, is they don't possess common sense, or, you know, they have this, what do you call it? We attach this term to other things, but they feel as though they're entitled to treat people like they're slaves or something. You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, boy. And I just want to add this too, because after I listen to it, you know, I always listen to shit before I upload it, right? And I just want to say this, because I don't want people to think that I think that all people with education are dumb. I'm just saying that some of the people that I know are, okay, they don't deserve the respect that they get or the accolades that they get because they're not that damn smart. They're not intelligent, okay? They don't have common sense. So I'm speaking of a particular sect of educated people, and I'm quite sure that there are people who are educated that listening to this video, they have degrees, that know exactly the type of people that I'm talking about. Okay, so like I said, I don't want to offend, you know, everybody that works in education, that has a degree, that works with our children, it works with the children of the country, that they're all idiots, because they're not. But I'm saying that there are a select few of them who have no business being in charge of anything, and that they got through college by using other people, looking at other people's papers, and all that other kind of stuff. They couldn't have made it on their own, studying on their own and things like that. So, you know, you just got some people that just, you know, they're smart enough to know how to manipulate others so they can advance themselves. That's the only thing that they have that's smart about them. Other than that, when it comes to doing things that make sense, they are as dumb as a box of rocks. And I just had to put all of this on record. They got the wrong one, because I remember one time, this should be funny to me. You know, I'm a secretary, so, you know, I'm real low level, right? I don't have a degree. I've been to college, but I haven't graduated from college. I just could not continue to sit in front of people, in front of a person who I know ain't got good sense. And when I was going to college, man, I'm telling you, I had like a few professors, because I think I only went like for the first 2 years I tried to go to college, right? And every last one of them, because I had studied long before I went to college, read up on a whole lot of stuff, because I was taking classes in psychology, sociology, and things like that. And of course, I had to associate everything with my experience in this country, as well as the red experiences of my ancestors. And so as I was listening to these clowns, and I'm like, that is not what I get out of the subject matter. And I'm like, they don't have a clue. I'm not going to keep paying to do this. And so subsequently, I dropped out. But of course, I have a huge student loan bill with no degree whatsoever that I have to pay. But I'm telling you, now that I've worked in the rent, because I used to really respect educated people. I thought they were really smart and, you know, were intelligent. You know, because they went to college, and the only respect I have for them is that they stuck it out and, you know, came through with their degree. That's the only thing, because I know they, what I've learned is that they're only good at fucking taking goddamn tests and passing them. As far as them having, you know, experience in life or, you know, consideration of other people or anything like that, people use their damn degrees so they can lord over other damn people, and I refuse to be lorded over. But I'm gonna tell you what happened a few times. One time in my office, now this is the office I'm in now, a few years ago, they brought in a refrigerator. You know, one of them little office refrigerators, right? So, now, mind you, you know, everybody's putting their stuff in the refrigerator and things like that. And so, eventually, you know, the refrigerator gets dirty because I'm not cleaning out the fucking refrigerator because I don't even goddamn use it hardly. You know, so they expected me. Now, check this. They really expected me, seriously, to clean out that refrigerator just like they expect me to water the fucking plants and shit like that. I'm like, that ain't what I'm hired to do. I'm not hired to be Hazel up in this bitch. Okay? And so, eventually, guess what they did? They took the refrigerator out. Rather than one of them motherfuckers clean it, they would rather take it out because their assumption is that I would be the motherfucker to clean the goddamn refrigerator out, water their goddamn plants and shit like that. I don't do that. You know what I'm saying? Now, here's another instance. Here's another instance. This happens on a frequent basis. My supervisor will ask me, Ifama, could you look on my calendar and see if I have such and such? And you sitting right in front of your goddamn computer. I'm like, well, my God, why can't you just go to your calendar and see what the fuck you got? Why are you yelling out of your office, sitting in front of your turned on computer, asking me to check your calendar when all you gotta do is click on the little icon up there and look at your own damn calendar, and 9 times out of 10, it's already up? Why would you do that? You know, I mean, I'm telling you, maybe it's to give me an order. I think you just can't go through one fucking day without having to give me a command that makes absolutely no damn sense. Okay, I mean, it's just unbelievable. And I just laugh at them because they're so damn dumb. You know what I'm saying? They come from these hick-ass towns up north and don't even know how to treat people and think they come down here, you know, to work at this system with all black people and, you know, just give stupid-ass orders. I mean, I don't have a problem with doing my job. But to do some dumb shit, like, I'm going to tell y'all the truth. This is what happened yesterday. Now, my supervisor had to go out of town to another, you know, town like Madison, Wisconsin, which is like 1.5 hours away from Milwaukee, to go to a meeting. Now, mind you, they got to drive 1.5 hours to go to an hour meeting. This is what white folk do. Crazy white people and black people do that's educated. They'll drive 1 hour, 2 hours to a meeting that'll only last 1 hour. I'm like, my God, you got all this technology and y'all don't even think to do a teleconference. It's unbelievable. Sometimes I'm just amazed at the stupidity. Okay, they could do a teleconference, ain't got to burn gas, ain't got to get in their cars, you know, worry about other bad drivers or anything. They don't do that. But anyway, let me tell you what happened. She gets all the way up there to Madison and has to call me to ask me, what is the subject of the meeting? Can you believe that? What is the meeting going to be about? You motherfucker, you done drove almost 2 hours and you don't even know what you're going up there for? I'm telling you, that was enough to, that was, I fell out laughing when she did. I just shook my head. I'm like, this is crazy. You know what I'm saying? I mean, sometimes I just think some people are just plain dumb. They stupid. Now, they smart in a way that what they do is they hire people who are smart. You know, and they use their brain. Now, that I'll give the educated people is that they've gotten their degrees to position themselves in life so that they can utilize other people's brains. Now, it's kind of like slavery. You know what I'm saying? The slave master, he would buy, you know, his human capital to do the work that he didn't know how to do, couldn't do, and all that other kind of shit. But he, you know, got them to do the work for him. It's the same concept. Is that you got all these dumb motherfuckers up at the top, but they utilize all the people at the bottom and their authority. See, this is what you call sanctioned authority. You know, not that they're all bad, but the society gives them the authority, even though they're not psychologically, mentally, or commonsensibly qualified to do it. Okay? But because they've jumped through the hoops of the world of degrees, they get the opportunity to tell, to give a demand and have it met. Even though it could be stupid as hell. And I'm going to tell you, I work in the educational system, honey. They come up with so many programs and plans and degrees, and kids' goddamn scores still fucked up. You understand? I mean, they ain't came up with not one fucking solution. Since I've been working there, that works for everybody in the whole district. But they keep spending money after money after money after money trying to figure out how to bring up the test scores. Now, mind you, I'm just a lowly little secretary with a fucking GED. And I guarantee you that I could come up with a plan to teach kids how to read and write and pass them fucking tests. You understand? But these folk here, I mean, they got all kind of stuff that they done came up with, all kind of programs, all kind of rationales to try to get the children's scores up and all that. Not whether they can read or fucking not or comprehend what the hell they're reading, just so their test scores will be up there on par with the rest of the world's, I guess. Honey, let me tell you something. We used to, as black people, we'd all sit in a cabin all ages and learn how to read. It didn't take all that special shit, none of that goddamn shit. Because once you learn the basics of reading, that's it. That's all. You got to comprehend the basics of reading. You know, what am I reading? Why am I reading? What is these syllables for? What do these words mean? Have your dictionary, goddamn it. And you'll learn how to read. From once you learn how to read, you can do math and any fucking thing else as far as I'm concerned. But I'm going to tell you. You talk about wasting money. These are the most waste. Educators are the field of education is the most wasteful field I've ever witnessed in my life, particularly public education. Now, there are some people who have, established these charter schools and things like that. And from what I don't go in them. You understand? But, you know, a couple people have reported back to me that there are some charter schools that are doing well. I mean, like off the chain with their students and stuff like that. But when we talk about public education, honey, all they do is have program after program after program. Oh, we gonna have this program, and it'd be like a, you know, maybe 1 year, 2 year program that they get a grant for to implement or something like that. And my God, after the 2 years, the shit is over. What is the results? How did it turn out? Then they write another grant for another fucking program. I'm telling you, it's unbelievable. These are these smart ass people that you let stand in front of your damn children and administrate the system that they're in, but they're not that goddamn smart. And see, that's why they try to really control parents, talking about the PTA and all that shit, but no, they want to keep parents under control, because I'm going to tell you something. If parents really knew what was going on up in that sucker around them tables, they'd pull their kids out of there so goddamn fast and teach them their damn selves, I swear. You know what I'm saying? And I know they probably do listen to my videos, and I'm glad they do. You know, because this is my time and it's my dime that I'm paying for, and this is my opinion about where I work at. You know, and I'm not saying that everybody is like that, because I've worked for some very intelligent individuals. I've worked for some very intelligent individuals that know exactly what they want. When they give you a task, they know exactly how they want it. They know what they want. They don't have to change things 20 and 30 and 40 fucking times. Let me tell y'all something. I've done things that I've had to change. I mean, waste reams of paper doing it because they wanted it a different way. I'm like, if you had a thought about it, I mean, really thought about what you wanted, then we wouldn't have to do all this change. Then, you know, and I'd be like, what? You know, and I'll be looking crazy. Well, what's that look for? I'm like, Lord have mercy, because I think it's dumb. Because I think you're stupid. That's what that look is really for. You know? I mean, sometimes I think these people are crazy. They got everything at their disposal. They don't really do shit all fucking day, but sit up in goddamn meetings, okay, and talk. That's basically what they do. You know what I'm saying? And they want to feel so damn important. And I'm like, you are just a waste of fucking air around here. You can get some real people in here that really know what the children need and how to do it and get this shit done. But no, they got to hire a motherfucker to make one line of the T and another motherfucker to cross the T at the top. I'm telling y'all, some of these jobs they have already, they don't even need them. if you really look at what they actually do, they really don't need those goddamn positions. You know what I'm saying? They really don't, seriously. But I guess the more positions you have, the more, I guess, powerful you look, or bigger you look, or in command that you look. I don't know. But honey, this shit is layered like a fucking 7-layer cake. And it's ridiculous. It's a waste of damn taxpayer dollars. I'm just going to put that on record. You know what I'm saying? And they use these public schools, I think, as a funnel of some sort. You know, it's a job program, in my opinion, because it's really, you know, the goal is to educate all the students. You know what I'm saying? And half of these people don't even respect half the students that come up in their classes. Not to mention the fact that a lot of these children are coming from situations that are horrendous. You know what I'm saying? And they think that they can get through a day just because they give them a free breakfast and they give them a free lunch. Well, their problems go deeper, way deeper than having a free breakfast and a free lunch. I'm just going to put that on record. And they done cut down on all the psychologists and sociologists and things like that that the schools really fucking need dealing with kids these days, and employing all of these other people. You know, all these specialists and implementers and all this coordinators and all this other kind of shit. When they need teachers, they need psychiatrists, and they need sociologists to deal with these students that come from these homes that are, you know, literally, I'm going to just put it like this, fucked up. You know what I'm saying? Due to society, how the society is. But they do need people that know how to deal with them. If you go have them in the classrooms, you know, all damn day, 30 at a fucking time, which I think is damn ridiculous. If they cut out some of these damn positions, they'd be able to have more classrooms, more teachers with less students, and able to handle a class than piling 30 and 35 kids in one fucking room with all kind of social problems and expecting a teacher to deal with these children. You know, you'd have more psychiatrists, you'd have more sociologists, you'll have more social workers, you know, that are trained to understand the dynamics of today's society and the people that they're serving. Not only just the people that they're serving, but the history of the people that they're serving. You know what I mean? You got to understand the history of the people that you're serving. And because you sometimes, particularly with us, you have to go kind of like, I'm telling you, you got to go back in African history, black people's history in America, to understand the psychology today. And if you a teacher and you don't know nothing about black people and their development here in America, you ain't going to be successful teaching a black child, because it's a whole lot of shit that your ass need to know as a teacher, black or white, because I know some black teachers ain't worth a damn, you know, for real, I do. So anyway, man, I was on my way to work. I'm here now. But I just wanted to do this little quick video. And I'm going to put this shit up, too. I don't give a shit. I'm going to put this video up because, you know, this is my rant of the day. This is my rant of the day on the system of education. And people, no, it ain't the system of education. It's people with fucking education. Degree people. People with degrees who think they're so fucking smart and entitled to give you stupid ass commands, but they don't have any sense. I mean, some of the things they want you to do are so dumb. You could do it by the time you walk out there and give it to me. You could have done it yourself. By the time you yelled it at me to do, you could have did that yourself. You know, I don't like people like that. You know, I don't care for people like that. I think they feel like they're entitled and they just have to tell you what to do. They can't go through a day without, you know, letting you do your daily routine, putting stuff in your inbox. They have to actually tell you to do something. That's how they feel in charge. Okay, that's how they feel in charge. And, you know, you have if you don't do it, they'll consider you this word insubordinate. Look that word up. Okay, I don't feel insubordinate to anybody. And I'm going to tell y'all why I don't consider myself insubordinate. Because I look up the word. I look up words, right? Origins of words and everything. So if you look up insubordinate, the N in insubordinate. Well, really, I'm going to just tell you it's an adjective. Insubordinate is an adjective. and 1849 on model of French insubordinone, or something like that, which is French, 1789, and then from in, which means not or opposite of, plus subordinate. So when you look up insubordinate, now you got to look up subordinate, right? Subordinate means to bring into a subordinate means to bring into a subordinate position. Subordinate, which comes from the mid 15th century, from medieval Latin subordinatus, which means placed in a lower order, made subject, and it's a past participle of subordinare, which means placed in a lower order, from Latin sub, which means under, plus ordinare, which means arrange. Now, when you look at insubordinate, which means not, or in of insubordinate, which means not opposite, which is why this language is just so crazy, because in means not an opposite of. So if I'm insubordinate, that means I'm opposite of subordinate. All right. That means that I'm not is to bring out of a subordinate position. If you look at the etymology of the word. Okay. So I don't think I'm insubordinate. I don't think I'm beneath any fucking body. Okay. That's why I say I'm not insubordinate whenever I ask a question or ask for clarity. I'm not being insubordinate. I never refuse to do a job that I'm asked to do, something that I'm asked to do, no matter how dumb I think it is. But I do believe that I have the right to ask the question. Why am I doing this? What is this for? You know, I mean, that, you know, but some people don't want you to ask no questions. They just want you to follow orders. I'm just not one of those people that follows orders. You know, like completely. You know, without questions. I don't follow orders without questions. I'll put it like that. I've always been like that. But I guess they want, you know, they got a term for, you know, when you, you know, don't want to, you know, you question why you have to do something. Because I always question. I said, so why am I doing this? What sense does it? I want to know, what sense does it make? You know, what is the end result? What? How does this step play into the end result? That's what I be wanting to know. And I ask now, you know, and some supervisors will probably say that I was insubordinate, you know. You know, or you know how they had that mammy character, they say that allowed to talk back to the master and shit like that, right? Maybe they thinking like that, but honey, look, I ain't nothing about me a mammy, and I think I have a right to ask, what is this step that I'm doing that makes this particular task gonna be to its completion, you know? But anyway, I'm trying to find my keys. But anyway, I just had to do that rant this morning. Please excuse the profanity. But that's just how I'm feeling today. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth seeker. Might be a truth terrorist sometimes. But today I'm a truth seeker. I'm always trying to find the truth of things. And with that said, I'm out of here. Gotta go in. Peace, everybody.